Few days back, I made a bridge rectifier using 4 1 and 4007 diodes, and for the filtration I used a cap. Also I used a 606 transformer for a DC output voltage of 6 volts. So now this setup gave us an output DC voltage of around 6 volts without the cap in, and with the capacitor in it gave us the peak value of the DC, which is around 9 volts. So the circuit may be good for running a LED or something like that. We don't get a constant voltage here. And now if you ask me to run my Arduino or some other microcontroller which requires a regulated voltage of 5 volts, probably I would not use this setup. So for this we need a constant DC output voltage of 5 volts. So now to get a constant regulated output voltage of 5 volts, we will be needing this kind of voltage regulating IC. This is a L7805 series voltage regulating IC. It will give us a constant output voltage of 5 volts. Similarly, L7809 will give us a constant regulated output voltage of 9 volts. Or we can also use Zener diodes rated of around 5.1 to 5.6 volts for the voltage. So before going in depth, let us now talk about the difference between the Zener diode and our voltage regulating IC. The main difference is that the cost. A single piece of Zener diode may cost somewhere between 1 rupees, and a voltage regulating IC may cost you around 10 to 15 rupees. Again, the kind of regulated voltage you will get out from a voltage regulating IC will never be same as a Zener diode. So for this I will be using this voltage regulating IC. So let us now see how to make the circuit step by step. Obviously we will be needing 4 general purpose diodes. This is 1N4007. And a capacitor for the primary purification, and the voltage regulating IC L7805, a breadboard, some wires, a multimeter to check the output voltage, and then I'll power my Arduino using it. So yeah, a microcontroller. And you can download the circuit diagram, just check the description. So as you can see in the circuit diagram, we need to connect this to relays. So what we can do is that we can use small pieces of wires like this. Similarly in this set. So the structure of a bridge rectifier is now ready. So in this kind of voltage regulating ICs, the leftmost pin is for the input, that is the output from this rectifier. And the center pin is the ground, and the pin at the right is for the output. So we'll get the constant output voltage from the rightmost pin, and the center pin is the ground or the negative. So what we can do is that we can simply insert the legs in some ports, say here like this, and now use small pieces of wires like this. So the point where the cathodes of the two diodes meet is the positive source of the DC output, and the point where the anode meets is the negative of the DC output. Take a wire from the positive output of the rectifier and connect it to the input pin of the IC, and similarly take another wire, connect it to the negative output to the ground pin of the IC. Something like this, and also connect the capacitor in between. While connecting the capacitor, keep one thing in mind, that the negative of the capacitor should go to the negative of the DC output, and the positive should go to the positive. Otherwise the capacitor can pee on your project with a fart. I'm using a 1000 microfarad capacitor. You can use one with a more capacity or a lesser one. The more capacitance, the better is the rectification. So now we can see that our circuit is ready. Just have a close up. So For the output part, I am using a red colored wire for showing the positive output and a green color wire for showing the negative output, like this. So everything is now ready. Let's power it on and check using the multimeter. So it's 10, let's check it using the multimeter, and then I'll be powering on my Arduino. So now, as you can see, you are getting a constant output voltage of 5.06 volts DC. So let us now try to power on a microcontroller. As you can see, I am not having any of those barrel jacks. So what I'm going to do is that I'll be using two alligator clips to juice it up. So let's try. So wait, yeah, it's the negative. Okay. So yeah, the Arduino is powered on. Arduino is turned on. So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like it, hit the thumbs up, and if you don't, thumbs down is always there.
Please subscribe to this channel for more such informative videos. Thank you and have a nice day.